Dear audience, we are going to present the presentation. The title of our presentation is Formation Dynasty Logging, done by Sarmov Temirlan, Jumakulov Aydana, and Tokhtiar Din Muhammad. Our supervisor is Ablay Nadir. So let's start. Dynasty logging. Dynasty logging is another application of gamma rays in gathering data about subsurface formations. The formation density log measures the bulk density of the formation. The formation density tools are induced radiation tools. They bombard the formation with radiation and measure how much radiation returns to a sensor. Let's talk about history of the tool. First appeared in 1957 based on the principle of gamma ray absorption by Compton scattering. In 1950s, single detector tool developed initially to measure bulk density. In situ as an aid to geophysicists in gravity meter interpretation. Early 1960s, accepted tool as a source for porosity. Late 1960s, dual detector system, compensated formation density, also known as FDC, to correct for borehole effects. And lately, early 1980s, development of lethal density tool LDT to measure photoelectric effect with bulk density. So moving forward, we should talk about uses of density tool. Its main use is derive a value for the total porosity of the formation. It's also useful in the detection of gas bearing formations and in the recognition of evaporites. So the gamma rays enter the deformation and undergo Compton scattering by interaction with the electrons in the atoms composing the formation. Compton scattering reduces the energy of the gamma rays in a stepwise manner and scatters the gamma rays in all directions. The tool consists of firstly a radioactive source. This is usually cesium-137 or cobalt-60 and emits gamma rays for medium energy. For example, cesium-137 emits gamma rays with an energy of 0.662 mega electrovolts. Long-range detector. This detector is identical to the short-range detector and is placed 16 inches from the source. To talk about the short-range detector, this detector is very similar to the detectors used in natural gamma ray tools and is placed 7 inches from the source. So this is the picture which represents our tool. The compensated formation density tools have one focused or collimated radiation source, one short spacing detector at 7 inches from the source, and one long spacing detector 16 inches from the source. The source at both detectors are heavily shielded to ensure that the radiation only goes into the mud cake formation, and that detected gamma rays only come from the mud cake or formation. A plough which removes part of the mud cake as the tool is pulled up the well. The borehole using a servo operated arm with a force of 800 pounds force. To talk about the radiation emitter. A radiation emitter and one detector are all that is necessary for a simple measurement. The early tools had only one detector, which was pressed against the borehole wall by a spring-loaded arm. Unfortunately, this type of tool was extremely inaccurate because it was unable to compensate for mud cake of varying thicknesses and densities. All the newer tools have two detectors to help compensate for the mud cake problem. The newer two detector tools are called compensated formation density logs, an example of which Schlumberger's FDC. However, hydrogen is anomalous and its presence perturbs the direct relationship. For this reason, the formation density tools are calibrated. The primary calibrations are made by inserting the tool into a block of pure limestone saturated with fresh water of accurately known density. Secondary or check calibrations are made in the wireline tool workshop by inserting the tool into large blocks of aluminium, sulfur and magnesium of known density. The direct relationship between Electron number density and bulk density indicates that no calibration is necessary. The depth of investigation of the tool is very shallow. The shallow depth of investigation of the tool makes it sensitive to borehole quality and is therefore necessary to interpret the formation density log together with the caliper log to ensure that the measured values is not an artifact of bad hole quality. The shallow depth of investigation also implies that in porous and permeable formations, where its main use lies, it only measures the invaded zone. The typical logging speed for the tool is 1,300 feet per hour, although it's occasionally run at lower speeds to increase the vertical resolution. The log quality is not as affected by logging speed as the natural gamma ray logs because much higher counts rates are obtained with the radioactive source on the tool. The vertical resolution at the typical logging speed is good, which is defined by the distance between the two detectors. The measurement point is taken to be halfway between the two detectors, as you can mention in the special pictures. The sensitivity to bad hole quality is exacerbated by the shallow depth of investigation that the tool has. The formation density log should therefore be run with a caliper tool, and the caliper reading should be used to judge the likely quality of the formation density log data. In the middle of the picture is demonstrated the borehole quality by the density tool. Finally, mud type. Drilling muds with high density or that absorb gamma rays efficiently, such as buried field muds, will affect the detector readings, as you can see in the two pictures. Then, we used a low density log is not a good tool for identifying most lithologies. This is because most rocks have a wide range of densities resulting from their varied mineralogical compositions and their variable porosities. The porosity F of a formation can be obtained from the density if the mean density of the rock matrix and that of the fluids it contains are known. When solved for porosity, we get the formula F equals rho ma minus rb divided by the difference between rho ma minus rho f, where rho b the bulk density of the formation, rho ma the density of the rock matrix, rho f the density of the fluids occupying the porosity, and porosity of the rock is labeled by the Greek letter. Moving forward, we should talk about if within a given shale interval there is a sudden change of density. The most likely explanation is that the formations above and below the change have been deposited in a completely different environment. The change is therefore an indication of possible unconformity. So we've got a log presentation. The formation density log is recorded in tracks 2 and 3 of the standard API, also known as American Petroleum Institute log presentation on a linear scale. The scale is in 1 gram per cubic centimeters and usually spans 1.95 to 2.95 grams per cubic centimeters, as this is the normal range for rocks. In the way of summing up, we want to present you the conclusion. The formation density tool, it's helped to design uses a radioisotropic source that emits gamma rays and counts the gamma rays that return to the tool after passing through the formation. Thank you for your attention. We hope that you will find this video very interesting and helpful for you. Good luck and be with us. With Timberland, Aydana and Dimash, we hope that we will get 5 points. Bye. And subscribe our videos and be with us with our channel.